Norton Antivirus has been around since 1990. That's more than three decades ago. So is it an ancient relic, or does it still hold up in 2025? In this Norton 360 Antivirus review, I'm gonna take a look and test Norton's capabilities and show you the pros and the cons of using this antivirus. As always, if you want to try Norton yourself, I'll leave a link to their latest discount deals in the description down below. All right, the most important thing for any best antivirus app is providing proper security. And since Norton has plenty of time to develop their tools, it's no surprise that it meets all of my main requirements. But let's do a deeper Norton review of security. The main and strongest layer of defense against malware is a scan, and the app has a few of them, a few different types of them. There's a quick one that checks areas of your computer that malware targets the most, and a full scan that checks the entire device, from files to boot records and running processes. Norton also has a smart scan that checks for security performance and network issues, pointing out potential vulnerabilities and ways to fix them. All right, buddy. And you can always run a custom scan on specific files, folders, or drives. However, scans only need to be run occasionally, and between them, features like real-time protection ensure your device's security. This one watches out for threats 24/7, so if any malicious files sneak into your device, you'll be notified right away. On top of that, Norton has a smart firewall that monitors incoming and outgoing network traffic. It's like airport security, but for your PC. Norton's smart firewall is actually one of the most advanced firewalls out there, as you can customize every little detail if you wish. Speaking of advanced stuff, Norton also comes packed with a bunch of extra features. First up, you get a password manager, even with the cheapest Norton plan. It's pretty basic, but it does the main job of keeping your password safe. What's pretty cool is that Norton throws in cloud backup starting from their most basic plan, which you can use to store your most sensitive files. On top of that, you can also use Norton VPN with most Norton plans. While it might not beat dedicated VPN services, it's a great bonus for private browsing, and I respect them for including an ad blocker, though I did notice it struggles a bit with video ads. Norton also has system optimization tools to keep your device running smoothly and safe web protection that blocks dangerous websites. For parents, there's a solid set of parental controls to help keep your kids safe online. And if you want to know what's going on with your personal information, there are tools for that as well, like the Dark Web Monitor tool that watches out for your info on the dark web. Or the Privacy Monitor. This one scans popular data broker sites for your details that you can then request to opt out of and have your data removed from. If you want to try this out for yourself, check the description for a link or scan this QR code. Both will take you straight to Norton's website and apply a special deal on their plans. Now, features are great and all, but disregarding all the flashiness, is Norton Antivirus good? Catching and removing malware. Norton scored maximum points in each category and even got a top product badge. But while preparing for this Norton Antivirus review, I wanted to see its capabilities for myself, so I ran my own test too. I got my hands on 50 malware samples, downloaded them into my testing PC, unzipped the file, and at first, I let real-time protection do its thing. It started quickly snatching up those files, and as you can see, in a matter of 3 minutes, it snatched all the files that were considered an immediate threat, leaving only 5 files in my malware folder. I then turned off real-time protection and ran a full scan as well. This one does a thorough check of the entire system. So it took longer, but in a matter of 13 minutes, Norton rounded up those 45 threats and got rid of them. What's impressive is that the scan took much less time compared to my Bitdefender and Total AV test, and Norton used less of my CPU as well. They improved a lot in this area during the past couple of years. Speaking of improvements, Norton had a pretty big UI update. The app used to be way more complicated than it needed to be, especially with features popping up in new windows and cluttering the whole screen. It took a few years of everyone complaining, but they finally listened to user feedback, and now the interface is really intuitive and easy to use. But what I really like about Norton is that it works great, whether you're a newbie or an advanced user. There are tons of customization options for those who want to get into the nitty-gritty, but at the same time, you don't have to touch any of that if you don't want to. I've got to be honest though, there are still a couple of downsides. Some people are complaining about Norton's upsell pop-ups, and yeah, I agree, they can be a bit annoying, but come on, most antiviruses do that, and they don't get nearly as much hate for it. A more significant con to keep in mind is that Norton can be pretty demanding on system resources. If you've got a really old laptop, you might want to think twice before getting it, as Norton does use up quite a bit of RAM. Other than that, Norton Antivirus software works pretty good on anything, Windows, Mac, Android, or iOS, you name it. Plus, getting started is super simple. You can download the app from Norton's website and you're good to go. The only thing that might be confusing in this process is picking the right plan, but I'm gonna break it down for you. First, while they do offer a basic plus plan, which is fine for rudimentary protection, I really wanna focus on their 360 package. Those give you way more bang for your buck. Like, you can get security coverage for a few devices instead of one. More features and, more importantly to me, more cloud backup space. I rely on it a lot to safely store all the material for my YouTube channel, especially since I test everything on multiple operating systems and download viruses deliberately. Anyway, that said, I'm a bit bummed out that Norton doesn't offer any plans longer than a year, and their renewal prices tend to climb much higher than the initial cost. But again, you don't have to pay full price. The coupon code from the description will automatically apply the best available discount. So can you use it to get the best antivirus price? So you can use that to get the best Norton antivirus price now, then disable auto renewal and use the discount code a year later to buy Norton again. But is Norton antivirus worth it? Well, to sum up this review, Norton antivirus is one of the most secure and powerful providers out there. It's efficient at spotting and removing malware and providing a set of additional tools, not just for device security, but for online privacy too. It has some cons, so consider your needs before getting it, but overall, I can definitely recommend Norton as a solid best antivirus contender. I hope this Norton 360 antivirus review helped you out. Let me know if you'd like me to compare this antivirus with another. Don't forget to drop a like, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.